I was born in on a small farm in central Victoria, a small sheep farm, where there were lots of rabbits. And as a young boy, like many other young farm boys in the area, I was very keen to hunt them because for us they were worth money. We made all our pocket money out of rabbits, usually by trapping or ferreting. As a kid, I was fortunate or unfortunate, depending on your point of view, to have seen the rabbit situation just before myxomatosis arrived. So I can remember back to around about 1948, 50. In that period, I was only a very young kid. But I can certainly remember going out one day to an uncle's farm, and my uncle stopped at one point and clapped his hand and said, "Look at that hill over there." And the whole hill appeared to move. It was like a sort of a grey blanket running up the hill, or sort of gently moving over the hill. And these were rabbits moving back into bracken fern. But after myxomatosis, there were more profound differences. Very soon after myxomatosis, in fact, there was hardly a rabbit to be seen in our district. And my father famously declared in a pub that rabbits were going to become extinct, and he was very quickly put in his place by an old rabbit trapper who knew rabbits a lot better than my father did. Yeah, later on, when I eventually finished up at university, I did ag science first, but was always more interested in zoology, and in fact finished up in that line of work. After a career of about 23 or 24 years in the Victorian government working as a vertebrate pest control researcher, I decided to leave and go on my own, and did a lot of work in mainly in the area of pest control, actual pest control itself, field pest control, but also doing work as a consultant. But I found that in the field work that I obviously needed machinery, and I started out using the sorts of machinery that I'd been used to dealing with when I was in the department, and that's how I first came across this bait layer that we have here today. If you look at the history of rabbit poisoning and the history of the method of rabbit poisoning, of course they started out in the early days, I guess doing a lot of it before any machines came in, simply by hand. But then fairly early on in Australian history, after rabbits came in, various companies actually made poison carts, and you will see occasionally, if you people who go around and looking at old equipment on farms, you will sometimes find the remains of an old rabbit poisoning cart. Now, these were horse-drawn carts, and of course they were, by the time I came onto the scene, the horse era was over, and those machines had all been long since retired off. So there was a need then to have a more modern version of that type of automated machinery, if you like, for putting out bait. And what happened was that most of the states had their own vertebrate pest control operations, and they tended to develop their own machines. So Victoria had its own type of machine, New South Wales had its, and South Australia, and so on. And ours, the one we developed in the government, was called the Alien Bait Layer, and that's the bait layer that we're dealing with here. And that was developed probably in the late 1950s, early 1960s, as a way of sort of updating, if you like, what had come earlier during the horse-drawn era. Because now, obviously, these carts were to be drawn by either Land Rovers, which were the main vehicle used by the department, or by tractors. The reason I got the cart was that by this time we were engaged in a number of field operations mainly for larger companies and for larger farms, and for some land care groups as well, to provide field control services. And I found that I needed a machine that could handle large volumes of bait, and the old bait layer that I'd been used to seeing or operating when I was within the department was, at this stage at any rate, the ideal choice for the sort of work that we were doing. I think it's important to realise, when we're talking about poisoning of rabbits, that it is not seen as a one-off or an overall technique of control of rabbits. Rabbit poising is very much a first strike, if you like, in a much more integrated approach to rabbit control. So normally poisoning is only used to get a rapid knockdown of populations. And once you've achieved that, you then move on to other methods of rabbit control, which give you much longer term and even permanent control. So I'm thinking here particularly of things like destruction of warrens, which is the most important way of getting rid of rabbits is to destroy their warrens. The other means that I'm talking about are things like warren ripping, that is complete destruction of warrens, or where that's not possible, the fumigation of warrens using fumigant chemicals which kill rabbits. Now, you will see what I mean here by saying that poisoning is a first strike or knockdown technique, because for instance, if you're fumigating a warren and there are very, very large numbers of rabbits in it, it may well be that with your fumigant that you're only killing a proportion of the rabbits in that warren, because the first few that die from the noxious gases actually block the gases from getting further down the warren to others. So in essence, the fewer rabbits you've got in the warrens when you fumigate them, probably the more effective your fumigation is going to be. And that's why your initial knockdown of poisoning is a good idea. But those other two techniques actually give you, and particularly warren destruction, give you long-term control of rabbits. Towards the end of my rabbit control, or my pest control career, I realised that the era, I think, of large-scale poisoning was going out. It was going out of fashion. There weren't the same resources within the various government departments to carry out the work via government, at any rate. Nor, I think, were as many farmers using the technique. By this time, rabbit calici virus had hit the scene. We'd already had, and that in conjunction with myxomatosis, had already done a pretty effective job in many areas. But one of the biggest reasons for the decline in the use of the rabbit poison cart was, I think, certainly in Victoria's case, was the fact that a lot more farmers started ripping their warrens. There were generous government subsidies given, and this was a very good step on the part of the Victorian government to offer subsidies for rabbit control by that technique, that is by ripping the warrens. And that worked particularly well in the part of the world that I come from, in central Victoria, in north central Victoria. And so that the need for the rabbit poison cart wasn't there anymore. And I could see the day when these indeed would become historical items. And I thought it important that we try and, as it were, keep a little vignette of what had happened in the past.